I often say that I live in an house, don't I? Well, I don't live in an house. I actually live in an igloo. More's the pet. I wish I did live in an igloo. I'd love to live in an igloo. Yes. Although I'd still ask where's the aircon. Because I love the cold that much. I really love the cold. I know, sounds weird. But I am weird. Anyway, because I live in a flat, other people use the same communal hallways. And recently, somebody moved in. They had a staffy puppy, made a bit of a mess. And the owners weren't very good at cleaning it up. In fact, they wasn't very good at paying the rent, allegedly. And they did a midnight flip. So not only did they do that, but they also left a lot of stains. And I'm sick to death of seeing them because I don't want strangers coming and thinking that the place is a poo dump. Because it really isn't. I saw this in Wilkinsons. It was £3.50. It's Dr Beckmann Pet Stain and Odour Remover. It says it's for carpets and upholstery. It says it removes new and dried in stains. Eliminates urine, vomit and faeces. This is something Amber Head staff must have used to clean the bed. Neutralises odours to prevent re-soiling. That's not really much of an issue. Gentle on colours and fibres. That's good, because I'm using it in the communal area. It's not really in my business to do it. I just don't want people who I know and don't know thinking that the place is a dump, like I've just said. Leaving carpets clean and odour-free. Special active ingredients eliminate odours, leaving a lovely fresh scent. The formula is tough on stains, yet gentle on colours and fibres. Dermatologically tested. Oh, really? Does that mean I can use it afterwards myself? Just use it as a as a scrub for me? That'll do the general undercarriage area. Always test colour fastness, yes. I'm going to give it a test first on the carpet under the rug. So then no one will know in case it leaves a stain. And it has got a brush and some bristles. And the bristles are quite soft, but firm enough. And the sponge is like one of them rough sponges, like the artificial sponge. Let's have a sniff, see what it smells like. Oh, you've got to open it with something. Scissors! I need scissors! Let's just stab that in there like that. I shouldn't really put my face too close, should I? Oh, it does smell nice. It smells of... It's not a citrusy smell, but it's got citrus notes. Yes. That smells, it does smell quite fresh. Yes. Right, I'm just gonna go test it on a small, inconspicuous area first. After 30 minutes, it says remove all residues of the product using a damp white cloth and allow the test area to dry completely. Do not oversaturate stained area as this could lead to fiber damage. Do not use on leather, suede, silk, velvet or any textile which can be damaged by water alone or oxygen-based bleaching agents. Certain stains can cause permanent discoloration which cannot be treated. Right, I'm going to now show you the stains that I'm hoping can be removed by this. Oh, it's dripping on my hand. Oh, it's dripping all over me. There's one of them. But this isn't the worst one. It's there. These are not stains you want to see on the way to someone's house. The bottle is a bit leaky as this bit drains off. But that's not my main worry. I have another worry, and it's not about staining and this ruining the carpet. It's what if this leaves a clean mark? Then that completely defies the problem, doesn't it? And now I've got I'll have a clean patch. Anyway, let's get on with the cleaning. I'm still waiting for the half an hour to pass on the test patch vest. Which reminds me, ladies, you should always be doing that when dyeing your hair. And blokes, of course, if you dye your hair. There's too many stories still in the 21st century of someone just douching hair dye on the red and then getting balloon face and then either looking ridiculous or even some people being so dissatisfied they dyed. don't do that. Don't dye from hair dye. Do a test patch. You're supposed to.
I think it's just leaving a clean mark. It smells nice though. Well, here we go with a test. I'm still gonna go ahead with the review.
just used it on four of the waste stains that really stand out. And the brush seems to hold up reasonably okay. I think I've used about half the bottle on them stains. It did give a good scrub, as you saw. The bristles are quite worn. The head, though, does have a tendency to be a bit too loose. I had to tighten it once because it started undoing it again because of the shape of the head. It wasn't too much of a problem, but, you know, the stains that I'm rubbing away, having to put my hand on it to tighten it back up again, I think it should have a more tighter mechanism to lock, because it's not a proper screw cap. You turn it and then it clicks into place. I think I would have preferred a proper screw tight fit shut. It's now always open as well, obviously, because you have to stab the lid and then you put this on and there's no way to cap that lid shut. The smell is nice. I'm now just going to go over it now with a damp cloth like it tells you to get rid of the residue. And if I haven't mentioned already, because I can't remember if I have or not, the bottle is quite leaky because that sponge has absorbed so much of the liquid. As it dries off, it starts dripping off and it just leaves blobs everywhere. So that's not good. Maybe there should be like a separate lid that you can put on it so that you can take the brush off and rinse it thoroughly or something. And then keep that separate and just put a proper lid on for next time you want to use it. Went over the residue with a damp cloth like it tells you. And something that I did, which it doesn't tell you to, was I thought I'd give it a help with a dab dry. And look at the state of the colour of that. I'm thinking it's going to work really well. I'm just going to go over with some more paper towel again. And I think, yes, because that is quite rank. It's lifted it off, and that them stains have been there for about a month, and it's that kind of carpet that you just know will never come clean, and it's a nightmare to over because it just won't over. So yeah, I think it's gonna work now that I've finished stamping and jumping and pressing the moisture out of the carpet. I was looking completely the wrong place, and that was annoying. My camera's the other way around. Well, it's not the other way around, but it's not where it usually is. And I need to solve that problem right now. There we go. Now I'm looking direct to the camera, not looking down. And yeah, I've been jumping up and down, getting all the moisture out as much as possible, but now I've still got to let it dry. Now there's two problems, like I said. One, it's either going to leave a clean mark, or two, it's going to be all right, but there's still going to be like an outline. But hopefully it'll take most of the disgusting brown colour that you clearly saw on the paper towel out. And it'll look less disgusting. And yeah, because what was clearing up that colour can only be one thing. Poo. And let's hope that now the poo has gone. It does smell much nicer now in the hallway. It smells of the product. But yeah, like I say, with its drippiness, I've had to leave it in the sink to let the brush evaporate. Well, the moisture from the brush and sponge evaporate. And hopefully be better. I shall show you now pictures of the finished result. I wonder how long it'll take to dry properly.
This is an hour later, and I think I've just managed to put clean patches in the carpet. Oh well, at least it's clean, the stains have gone. Yeah, it's much, much, much better. Problem is now though, they're going to have to send someone round to actually clean the rest of it.
In conclusion, it's really, really good. I think it's done quite a good job. Bearing in mind the type of carpet, the carpet that will never come clean, the carpet that will never hoover. It's in a communal hallway, which is probably the worst place to put that kind of carpet. It's done a really good job at cleaning it up. I think I could recommend that you get it, because probably if you're using it for your house or in your flat, in your actual home, chances are it's not going to be left for a month. If it can pull up month-old stains, it definitely should be able to manage a couple of minutes or a couple of hours if you've been out on your comeback and your cat, your dog, your bird, your mongoose, what other pets might you have, giraffe, has made a mess. Yes, absolutely. I think it's good. I'm happy with that. This is not a paid for promotion or anything like that. I don't know who Dr. Beckmann is. Never heard of the fella or lass in my life. Never used their products before. This is the first time I've used it. and I think it's great. Yes, it seems to have done everything it needs to do. It does smell lovely and fresh. It's a shame this is not future YouTube, as I often say, where you could smell what it is, because it actually smells really good. The only downside is I would have liked a proper sealable lid, because even though it's got no warning signs, it does say keep out of reach of children. But what happens if your cat knocks it over? I do think it should have a proper resealable lid. And that's my only negative I've got to say about this. Yeah, anyway, thanks for watching. Scrabs, bye. Bye. I shouldn't really wave a slightly soiled sponge and brush in your face, should I? Sorry, everyone.